Actor and far-left loudmouth Seth Rogen says living in LA is lovely, despite admitting that his car has been broken into about 15 times. No, this isn't the Babylon Bee. Rogen's remarks were prompted by YouTuber Casey Neistat tweeting this. So our cars got robbed this morning because Los Angeles is a crime-riddled third world shithole of a city. Rogen responded, dude, I've lived here for over 20 years. You're nuts. Haha, it's lovely here. Don't leave anything valuable in it. It's called living in a big city. I mean, yeah, earlier this summer, Los Angeles experienced its deadliest month in over a decade. Homicides are up 49% compared to 2 years ago. But hey, I guess being murdered is just part of living in a big city too. I can still be mad though, right? Feel so violated. You can be mad, but I guess I don't personally view my car as an extension of myself. And I've never really felt violated any of the 15 or so times my car was broken into. Wait, so it's nuts to say that LA is a crime-riddled third world shithole, yet you've had your car broken into 15 fucking times. Yeah, kind of proving his point there, aren't you? It's lovely here. My car has been broken into 15 times. Once a guy accidentally left a cool knife in my car, so if it keeps happening, you might get a little treat. Talk about Stockholm syndrome for the uber rich. I found a diversity trinket in my smashed up ransacked SUV. How cute! Talk about perma cooked utopian self-delusion. Also observe the jaw-droppingly flippant liberal elite celebrity privilege on display here. Be minimum wagey. Car has been broken into 11 times. Every time have to choose between replacing window lost property or eating that week. The literal millionaire. Dude, just like don't care, LA is lovely, dude. Weed, LMAO. Poor people can't afford to have their shit stolen, you pampered, arrogant twat. My car got broken into recently. I was pretty bummed about it. But I think whoever broke into it was probably more happy to steal from it than I am sad to lose my belongings. The total happiness in the world increased. So whatever, dude. Weed, LMAO. Cities like LA and San Francisco are turning into crime-riddled third world shitholes for two primary reasons. After the George Floyd riots, they started defunding the police departments, reducing the number of officers available to respond to crimes. They've also passed laws that reduce punishments for theft of property from a felony to a misdemeanor. Academia and legacy media are also pushing the narrative that describing group burglary as looting is racist. Given all that, is it any wonder that scenes like this have become commonplace in California, with mass lootings of major stores now happening virtually on a daily basis?
Like, just let people steal shit, dude.
But according to Seth Rogen, bedlam, lawlessness, and mass looting is just part of living in a big city. What would he do if Tyrone and friends came to his mansion house? Smile, invite them in, offer them coffee, and sit back and marvel at how lovely it all is. To get exclusive content, early access, behind the scenes stuff, and to personally interact with me, please sign up for my community at pauljosephwatson.locals.com. Link in description, and thank you for your generous support.